Whey, interestingly enough, was a waste product of cheese manufacturing. They have countless companies selling whey, but there's three basic kinds that the consumer has to know about. The first one is called whey concentrate. Whey concentrate has anywhere from about 70 to up to maybe 87% protein. It contains some lactose. The feature of whey concentrate, it has what they call bioactive peptides in there, which have a lot of health benefits. Then you have whey isolate, which is the highest whey protein as far as protein content. It's 90% or more. But whey actually does have a biological value of 105, which is the highest biological value of any known food protein. So whey isolate is very pure protein, 90%, very little lactose. The third type of whey protein is called whey hydrolysate. And this is basically a pre-digested protein. The feature is that it's digested very rapidly, and a couple of studies show that it increases workout recovery.
Which ones do you take? You know, the data consistently comes back to show that because of these sugars and fats that are attached to proteins, there's probably something there that makes them very anabolic. So what my recommendation for people is, if you're just trying to gain muscle and you're trying to just gain size, or so you're a young kid on a budget, or you're an adult who's never exercised, is trying to get on a diet, and you're just entering into it, just take a whey protein concentrate. Find a good quality brand that's inexpensive, you'll do just fine. If you're on a ketogenic diet, if you are truly trying to cut out sugars and fats, take an isolate. Whey isolates are very low in fats and sugars. If you're lactose intolerant, and if you've been diagnosed lactose intolerant, you can still take a whey isolate unless you're hypersensitive, which most people are not gonna be so sensitive to lactose that an isolate won't do fine for them.